Hanna's Into the Wild. From what I understand, you got a call early in the morning from your colleagues in Columbus that Mrs. Thompson was heading to the zoo to take the animals back, supposedly with a horse trailer. From what I read, what went through your mind when you got that call?
Well, like you, Anderson, I mean, I went to New York last night to do some shows this morning, and all of a sudden I get a call at 5:30 this morning saying she's coming to get the animals. I said, these guys have been up, they only got it late last night. I said, you're kidding me. There's no way. You got to take them back there where carnage happened a week ago? It's impossible. And I said, you've got to call the governor. And I said, plus they're in quarantine. I just happened to say they're in quarantine. They call the state. The state goes, what are you guys talking about? You know, so the governor issued the order, or not the governor, the head of the Department of Agriculture issued the order. They're to go nowhere because, Anderson, even the animal from an accredited AZA zoo, American Zoological Aquarium Association, even we, the 220 zoos and aquariums, we go through stringent processes of being accredited. One of those is every animal, I don't care if it's from San Diego or our animal goes to San Diego, every animal is put in quarantine, Anderson, for at least 30 days, and beyond, depending on what type of animal, could be longer. So we just remember something. These animals went through you know what last week, so we bring them there to get them calm, get them eating, which they're doing now. They look pretty good, and the testing was to start, as a matter of fact, any day now, but obviously we don't want to put the animals down again after they just got there last week. So none of these animals are going, I said, those animals aren't going anywhere. I don't care if it's state or federal law because we've got to figure out what to do with the animals if to see if they're free of disease because of our collection at the zoo.
Do you have any reason to believe? It's unbelievable. Do you have any reason to believe the situation at her property is an appropriate location for these animals to be living? I mean, what were the conditions like? Is she capable of caring for these animals?
Anderson, the question is, her husband went to prison for a year. She left him. Remember that? My question is, I understand that she didn't go back to take care of him. So now all of a sudden, she wants the animals back. She said she has a love for him. She may have a love for him, Anderson, but you don't love something and put him in the horrid conditions that were up there. There's no way over my dead body, and it might be that pretty soon, that those animals are going to go back there to the same conditions, and I'd wake up tomorrow morning saying, well, and let's say they got out again or something happened. Can you imagine what they'd think of not just the zoo, but the state of Ohio? Are we crazy? And these new rules coming up, Anderson, I'm going to tell you something. They're going to be the most stringent rules of any state in the United States of America. And there's a committee set up, and they're going right now, for example, perimeter, I haven't announced this yet, perimeter fencing, inspection by a veterinarian once a year. There'll be people made up of the Ohio Department of Natural Resources, a zoo person, a HSUS person. About five people inspect that place once a year. Plus, then you have to have the proper habitat, proper insurance policies, as well as acquisition disposition, where the animals come from, where they're going to. Out of all those few things I just mentioned, there's going to be some more, by the way, I'd say about 90% of the people or more won't be able to have a pet lion or a grizzly bear running around in the backyard.